Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this new webinar. In this webinar, we will see some of the new features that we have released with the new Ixpat Ultimate Service Pack. So we released the Ixpat Ultimate Service Pack on 27th of October. If you have a valid expert for Ixpat Ultimate, you will have the possibility to download and use these new features that we introduced in this module. So what we will see during this webinar is, first of all, a very short introduction on what is Expert and the service packs, just for who of you who do not remember or who do not know. And then we will see some of the new functions that we have included in this service pack. In particular, we will focus on the Xtilt. We will see the new function related to the CAD, GNSS, TPS, surface and volume, and COGO. And COGO, in particular, we will see the traverse calculation. If you have any question, you can write your questions in the chat, and I will reply to your question at the end of the webinar. Also, I would like to remember you that then, after a couple of days, also we will upload the video on our Geomax website. Okay, we can start. So let's start to have a very short introduction on what is Expert and the service pack. So with Ixpat Ultimate, you know, is our field software for Android, for working with manual, robotic, total station, and GNSS. We offer two different, what we call here, products, and they are Ixpat Shield and Expert. What are the Shield Expert? So Shield is the software maintenance. So software maintenance is always free of charge. So it is not even after you buy the software. What we call the Shield is always included without any expiration. And what is included in Shield? In Shield is included all the bug fixing, the improvement of existing functions. So all these kind of upgrade, they are provided for free, without any time limitation. And then we have what we call Expert. So Expert instead is a maintenance, is a license that allow to use a new function that was not available when the software was purchased the first time. So in general, we guarantee two software release for Expert every year, but could also be more, a minimum of two. And after the first activation is always guarantee 1 year of Expert free of charge. So we have these two type of what we call maintenance, so Shield, bug fixing, and Expert. So most of the function that we will see today, they are only available if there is a valid Expert license, okay? Because most of the function we will see today, they are new function that we have just released in this service pack two. However, even if you do not have Expert, you have probably received an upgrade on the 27th of October, because even if you do not have Expert, you have downloaded improvement of function and bug fixing, so everything that is included in Shield. Where you can check your Expert status, you can check Expert status just opening the software, clicking here, and then you have the information about the Expert. So you can see the expiration date. As I said, you have 1 year Expert included after the first activation, and then it is needed to renew if you want to use the new function that we will see today. If you want more information about Expert, the cost, how to renew it, you have to contact your Geomax distributor. Okay, let's start to see what is available in this Expert. So we already released this upgrade on 27th of October. So if you have Ixpat Ultimate upgraded and with a valid Expert, you will see this function in your setup. Okay, let's start with the Xtilt. So Xtilt is probably the biggest news in this update. And what is Xtilt? So Xtilt is a system that only using internal algorithm of our software and the sensor that are included in Android controller, so inclinometers and other sensor, this system allow to calculate very accurately the inclination of a pole. And this is independent if it is a GNSS or RTPS pole. It works with GNSS and TPS. It requires a very fast calibration that we will see later. Is not influenced by magnetic field or other interferences. And we can use it for two different functions. One is that we can visualize the electronic bubble on the controller. So we can, with GPS or total station, we can visualize directly on the survey page or on the stakeout page the bubble of the pole. So instead of looking at the bubble on the top, on the pole, we can check the bubble directly on the screen. And also the instrument do not measure if we are not leveled. Second, we can measure, and this is probably the most interesting, we can measure hidden point with two pole tilted measurements. And this is what also I will show you here live with a couple of videos. So let's start with the first one. So as I said, the first possibility is to visualize the bubble here. As you can see on the screen, if you open the GPS or TPS settings, you have the possibility to activate the bubble. The bubble means that, as you can see, so the same bubble that you have on the pole now is duplicated digitally, we can say, on the screen of the tablet. It is also very accurate. It is important to have a stable holder for the controller, and then here you can visualize the bubble directly on the screen. Second function that we have is the dual tag. So the dual tag, we can work with the GPS that before was only available for the Zenith 35 tag, now is available for all the GPS. So this new function is available not only for our tilt receiver, the Zenith 35 tag, but it is available for all the receivers, the GNSS receiver in our basket, even the old receiver. So even if you have an old Zenith 25 receiver that maybe you purchased 5 years ago, you can use this function, because this function is independent from the GNSS receiver, because it's only using the technology of the controller and the algorithm of the software. How this dual tag works? This dual tag method allows to measure hidden point, for example, a corner of a building, or I don't know, a marker that is under a car, or a point where you cannot stay vertical with the pole, in a very, very fast and easy way, just taking two tilted pole measurements. And then the software automatically calculates the position of the point. What is the accuracy? In general, we have seen that the accuracy is the same accuracy of the GPS. So if, for example, with the GPS, you have a 1 centimeter error, 8 millimeter error, if you measure a point with the dual tag method, maybe you will increase of some millimeters the error, but not so much. In general, you have a very good accuracy if your tilt angle is no more than 30 degrees. Then it's not a limitation of the algorithm, it's a limitation because if you tilt, for example, the pole 50 degrees, then the antenna is not designed to work in this way. So you will have multi-path error related not to the inclination method, but to the GNSS receiver. Let's see with a short video how this system works. Okay, so here, it's me again. So here we want to measure, So we want to measure, for example, this point that is under 50 centimeter here roof. So we have not the visibility of the satellite. So this method works very well. So if we want to use this method, here in XPAD, we click on tools. We select tools, hidden point, tilted pole. Okay. Now the software, we have just to do a very fast calibration. How is the calibration done? We just need to stay with the pole vertical and we press calibrate. So, because with this function, the receiver is, sorry, the software is calibrating the electronic bubble. Okay, so you see it only takes few seconds, and then we can take two tilted measurements. Here you can see the here you can see the tilt angle. So here you have, so you can check what is your vertical tilt angle and the horizontal also. This second information is the horizontal angle between the two tilt measurements. Why we visualize this information? Because there is also a geometric rule to have the best result. So the best result, they are between 40 degree, 120, 130 degree horizontal angle between the two tilt measurements. So in general, if you are measuring an hidden point, you want to have a 90 degree angle. More that what you will have it. But anyway, we prefer to enter this check, so you will not have any error. So you will have the best possible accuracy. See, that's all. You just measure two tilt measurements, then you raise the poll, and you click on store, and you save it the point. Just very, very fast and very easy. And then this is also a great news. We have also the possibility to do the same with the robotic, because we are not using the sensor of the receiver. So we are not using any hardware installed in the antenna. We are just using software and hardware inside the controller. So we can also do the same with the total station. This is really something unique in the market. There is no other similar solution. Let me show you even here how it works in a video. So here you can see again. So I want to measure this point with the robotic total station. In this case, I click here on measurement mode. Ah, sorry. Okay, now you can see also the mouse. You can click here on direct measure, and then you select tilted pole. And then the procedure is exactly the same. So first of all, the software suggests you to do the calibration. So for sure you have not to do every time the calibration, only the first time. But anyway, if after maybe some job you want to calibrate again, but the procedure is so fast that at the end it's not time consuming. And then again, you take one shot in one direction. In the second one. And then the software is calculating in a very accurate way this point. Okay, here the point that otherwise, if we are not using this method, the traditional method means, for example, to use the disto, because maybe we do an hidden point, so by two distance or by distance and offset. But for sure, this method is much more accurate and much more fast and easy also to do. What is the accuracy if we use the total station? There is not a standard rule to estimate what is the accuracy. So we did several different tests at a different distance, different type of prism, different orientation. What we have seen is that in general, we have an error of more or less 1 centimeter. That is in general error. And this error is not depending on the distance from the total station. So you have the same error at 15 meters or 200 meters. So more or less we estimate 8 millimeter, 1 centimeter of error using the dual tag with the robotic total station. In general, so we have to consider that if we measure an hidden point with distance and distance method or distance and offset, anyway, the accuracy will not be so good. So if you have any question about this, please just write in the chat, and then when we finish the webinar, I will reply to your question. Okay, Xtilt, so what are the benefits that we have discussed? So talking about the GNSS, it is compatible with all the GNSS supported by XPAD. It is also compatible with all manual and robotic total stations supported by XPAD, since we only use the hardware inside the controller. allow to measure hidden point in a faster way than what we traditionally do, especially for the robotic, but also for the GPS is a unique solution in the market, because the other brand also they have this solution, but they work with the hardware inside the antenna. We are also compatible with all the antenna that do not have any specific hardware. Accurate result, as we discussed, not influenced by magnetic field, so we can use everywhere, even very close to a car, and the calibration is very fast. Just a couple of recommendations. What is our recommendation to have the best result? For sure, to have stable controller holders, because so we use the sensor inside the controller, so the controller has to be the holder has to be very rigid to have the best result. Also, the pole on the bubble has to be calibrated, because in the initial calibration, we use the physical bubble on the pole to calibrate the electronic bubble. So for sure, it has to be calibrated. And also, as we said, the best solution is when the horizontal angle between the two tilt direction is more or less 90 degree. But anyway, this value you can check in XPAD, so you have not the risk to make any mistake. But to have the best result, we suggest 90 degree. But even if you use 40 on 100 degree, it's fine. We have a check anyway in XPAD to evaluate this angle. Okay, now let's change argument. So what are the news that we have in this expert about the CAD? So first of all, we have a function to edit the polyline. So let me show here an example. Okay, just a second that I open the tablet. Okay, perfect. Okay, now we are connected to my tablet. So let's open the CAD. Okay, so this is a job, for example, that we have done. So what news here we have? We have the possibility to completely edit a polyline. What does it mean? For example, this polyline that you see here in CAD is a polyline that I measured during my job. Then I forgot a point. So I measured all the point, and then I realized that I forgot to measure the point 105. Okay, and then how I can do? For sure, I can write maybe a note, then when I am in office, I open this data in CAD and I edit the drawing. Now I can also do directly here. So I can select edit. Then here we have this new function, edit polyline. So I select the polyline, and then here you see that I have different function. For example, I can select insert vertex. I select the segment where I want to insert the vertex, and I select the point. And you see, I can easily edit my polyline. So for example, if this was a point that I forgot to include in the polyline, it's very easy and I can do it directly from here. At the same way, I can also do it from here. I can also select the polyline and click on edit. I can, for example, delete a segment. I can delete a vertex of the polyline. I can close or invert. So for example, I can, you see, delete this vertex of the polyline. And then, for example, I can close. So you see, here I have all a full edit tools to manage my polylines. So this really simplify the job. Here also we have a new snap nearest. For who of you already use often CAD, I think it's nothing new, but I can quickly show you. So here, for example, I select draw point. Here, if I open the snap, you see that we have a new snap nearest. What does it mean? It means that if I click on a line or on an object, it will create directly the point where I click. So for example, you see I can click here and it's easily creating the point on the line. Okay, so this is the new snap command nearest. Photo sketch symbol. Here it's just a small upgrade, but it helps you to show directly here in the CAD if we have also a photo for this point. So you see that, for example, for the point 109, we have this icon. This means that when we measured this point, we also took a photo. And here from the CAD, we have also the possibility to long click on the photo and immediately we can open the sketch. Okay, so very a small upgrade, but can be useful if during our job we also take the photo of the points. So for the documentation, it's much more easy to be able later to check the job on the controller. Okay, another small function here on the CAD, it's about the possibility to colorize the point name, the label of the point, using the same color of the layer. So let me show you here. We can activate this option here in the CAD settings. Here, point, sorry. You see here we have this function called the point label color from layer. If I activate, this is the result. So why we have this new color? Just because the point 100, 101, 102, they are on a layer with orange color. The point 108, 109, they are on a different layer. Okay, so probably the 108, 109, they are on the utility layer. It's blue, so the points are colorized blue. So if I'm working with layer and I have different point, different codes, this option for sure will help me to better identify the different point typology. Okay, GeoTIFF raster map format. So with this upgrade, we are also compatible to import the TIFF and the GeoTIFF format. So GeoTIFF is a georeferenced TIFF. If we import in XPAD, is already correctly scaled and in the correct position. Before, this format was not available. Was only available on XPAD Windows Mobile. Okay, let's change. So we have seen the XTilt. We have seen the new features in the CAD. And now let's see the new features about the GNSS. So first of all, about the GNSS, now we have the possibility to view the list of mount points of a network, not only the list of the mount points, sorry, but we can also visualize the mount point on the map. Let me show you here again on my tablet where we have this option. So, sorry, here. Okay, so this is the standard profile. Okay, so this is a profile of a GPS that I am configuring. Here I have selected the server, here I selected the mount point. Okay, before we only had this list, so we had the list with all the station. Now we have also the possibility to visualize where these antennas, they are on the map. Okay, so especially if I'm working not with, for example, if I work with SmartNet, I will not use so much this function because with SmartNet, for example, I only work with IMAX, MAX, virtual reference station. So I have not physical antennas. But if I am using a network where I directly get the correction from a single antenna, this function will be useful also to understand what is the nearest antenna to my position. Okay, let's change argument. Now we see here the GNSS. Okay, this is a function that we also included for the total station. So now we have a new way to visualize the level of battery of GNSS and TPS with a warning. So the warning will be at 20, 10, and 5%. So you will have a very visible message inside the controller if the battery is going down. And then this is very interesting. We have the possibility to visualize the number of used satellite. So what this means? Means that before, if you remember, if you was already using XPAD, you remember that we have not, so we was visualizing the total number of GPS, GLONASS, Beidou, Galileo, and then the used. But the used satellites was never the sum of the other satellites. Why? Because the GPS, GLONASS, Beidou, and Galileo information that we was visualizing was the number of tracked satellites. But then the receiver do not use all the tracked satellites because it can only use for positioning a satellite if it is in common on the base. Maybe it is a new satellite still not supported by the firmware. Maybe it is a satellite that maybe it's very noisy, so the measurements engine just don't use it. Before was not so understandable this information, because also you had not the possibility to see how many Galileo I'm really using. Now you have this possibility. So when you open the GPS status, you will see what are the used satellites. So you will see that, for example, as you can see in this screenshot, I track 5 Galileo. So I have 5 Galileo that I can see here in the sky plot, but I use only 4 Galileo. But these 4 Galileo are really used to calculate, and they are fixed. So these satellites are fixed. TPS, so what we have new in relay related to Total Station, okay, custom prism. This was a function that was requested quite often. So now we have the possibility to customize more prism. So before it was only 2 prism, if I am not wrong, that was possible to customize. Now we have the possibility to customize more prism. And also it is much more clear the different prism that we can select. So where we can select, open this page, we click here on prism, then we select target manager. Okay, and here you can see the target list table. Okay, and here you can click on add and create the new prism. Okay, and here you can create how many custom prism you want. And you see, this was just introduced in the really last update. We have also the possibility to change the icon. So if you do, if you create maybe 3-4 custom prism, here you can also say, okay, one is a prism, one is a 360, one is a mini prism. So you can also customize the icon. Okay, second function related to the Total Station is the last user poll. So this looks a small upgrade, but it's really useful. This allows, when we select the poll high, to select the poll high from a list of last used poll heights. So if we often change maybe 2 or 3 heights of the poll, this option is very, very useful, because it's allowed to save some time. We do not have every time to digit the new poll high. This is the same, we already said, also for the TPS, we have new level, so new warning to inform about the battery level. TPS search prism shortcuts. So this is similar to also what we included for the GPS. So you know that if you need to search for the prism, in general, we click on this button. You see, okay, now it's a new version, so you have also the tips tricks. If you do not remember this function, sorry. So before was necessary to open the robotic page and then click here, unlock or search left or search right. So with this new function, we can skip one click. And if we need to search for the prism, we just long click here. You see, much more fast. Surfaces and volume. Here we have a couple of new function that I will explain you quickly. So one of the new function is the automatic selection of surface. This is useful when you have in a project a lot of different surfaces. In general, we have seen that happen if it is, for example, a road project or big project, and you have many surfaces loaded. And sometimes it's not easy to understand, okay, now I am here, what is the right surface to stake out? With this option, auto select surface by position, the software will automatically select the correct surface for your position. Second function is regards of the volume calculation. And with this new option, when you calculate the volume between two different surfaces, the two different surfaces, they can be in different jobs. So let me show you quickly an example. Here I have already a job with a surface. So here we already have a job with a simple surface, okay? Just a very simple surface. Now we want to calculate the volume between this surface and another surface, but the another surface, the reference one, is not in this job, but it is in another job. So we click on volume, calculate volume. Here we select surface difference. Okay, here is the surface two, is the surface that we have in this job, but then I select the surface to calculate the difference from a different job. And for example, I select this one, okay? And then I proceed with the calculation. And here I have the result. Okay, last function, so big news in this upgrade is the traverse calculation. So we introduced, we are talking here about a total station for sure, the possibility to calculate a traverse directly in the field. Before it was not possible. If I was measuring a traverse, the only solution to estimate the error and adjust the position of the station was to export the data for an office software. Now we have the possibility to estimate the error of a traverse directly in XPath and then adjust the data. So let me show you here an example. Okay, so let me, here I already have a job that I prepared for this webinar, okay? Now we open COGO and traverse calculation. Okay, here we select the station that are part of this traverse. So we start, for example, from station one and I click on plus. Now I select the second station. So in this case it's a closed loop traverse, so we select station two, and you see then the software automatically check the different measurements that I have done in my job and automatically complete the traverse. So this is a small example, 65 meters. I click on next. Here I can select my tolerance, okay? So how I want to estimate the tolerance. I can use this formula or I can select fixed value. Okay, here is just how I want to set the tolerance for my traverse. And then I select how I want to distribute the error. So I will have three errors: angular error, linear error, elevation error. So the software will calculate these three different errors and then will distribute the error to the different points. Here I click on calculate. You see here I have the tolerance. So the tolerance is what I have defined using this formula and the value that I have. Then I can click on next. Here I have the possibility to adjust the traverse with the calculation. So it will adjust the coordinate of the station and the details point. I can for sure overwrite this data or much better, I can create a backup and it will adjust the data. Okay, just because maybe some of you are asking, is there the possibility to export a report? We are working on it, so it will be ready very, very soon. Okay, so for this moment you can only calculate, but we are already working also to export a report. Okay, let's finish the presentation. The last features of this new service pack. So we have the possibility now to copy the jobs between different sites. This is very useful if you are used to work with different sites. Now, if you want to copy the data between two different sites, if enough that, sorry, so these are my jobs. So I want to copy a job from this site to another one. So I can just, for example, the copy traverse loop, I long click on this job and then I can select, for example, copy. I select the other site and the job has been copied. Small upgrade, but useful. Okay, okay, here I will spend just a couple of minutes to explain this new function. This new function allow to enter the codes in a parametric way. What does it mean? It means that if we use this symbol, the hashtag, okay, together with the code. What we enter here in the code instead of the hashtag will be copied inside the description. So let me show you an example that probably is more easy than to understand. So let's open the codes page. Okay. And I create a new code. Okay. So for example, I call it, I don't know. Let's call, distance DT, and then I use the hashtag. Okay. And so let's do in this way, DR, right. Okay. The distance right with the hashtag. Okay. And then as a description, I write, okay, offset right hashtag. Ah, sorry, it's the auto correction. Ah, okay, centimeter. Okay, so this means that when I will use this code, it will copy the information instead of the hashtag here in the description. So if I forget, I can click here on info, and you see here also we have a reminder how this system works. Okay, let's try. So I will go in survey, for example. Okay, no calibration. So I don't, here you see the bubble, but I do not use it. Okay, so I will use the code. For example, I call it the DR, okay. And then I enter, for example, 20. Okay, and then I measure this point. Ah, sorry, let me use reflectorless. Okay, now if I open my point, okay, DR20, you see that this information that was inside the hashtag has been copied here. So right offset 20 centimeter, right 20 centimeter. Okay. So this can be useful if, for example, I'm doing a survey and I'm measuring, I don't know, the lamp pole or some object that I always have to enter in the description, the offset. In this way, it is much more easy. So I can customize a code also with an information that automatically will be moved to the description. So if I want, for example, for a list of points always to enter what is the offset, in this way it is much more easy. Okay, here you can see some example. I can also use multiple code. Okay, so if I use something like this, you see it will be lamp post distance 25 centimeter from measured point, because it will use the description of the code LP, then the description of the code D25 with the number. Okay, so I hope it's clear. Okay, we also included some upgrade for the GIS feature. In particular, now it is possible to sort the number of the different GIS features. We have the possibility to customize the order of the instrument. So this is useful if I have a different profile. So maybe for the GPS, I have internal GPS with a SIM card, with another SIM card, maybe connected to a network, another network. Here I can sort the list of the instrument to move the most used profile in the top. This is more for our German customer. So we have the possibility in the ROD module to import the RIB format. It is a format for the ROD, but I think it's mainly used in Germany. This is interesting. So if you do not know, but in XPAD Ultimate, we have also a module for the bathymetry. So bathymetry means that we can connect a GPS receiver and an echo sounder to make a to do a bathymetric survey. So far, we was only compatible with the SonarMite echo sounder. Now we are also compatible with the NMIA format for the echo sounder. EMEA format is a standard format, so most echo sounder in the market, they stream the format in the EMEA, so now we increase the compatibility of our XPAD bathymetry with probably all the echo sounders in the market. And then, if you have these two laser distance meter, this is a good news for you, because now we can use these two distance meter, the Bosch GLM series and the Cosmo series by ADA Instruments, together with XPAD Ultimate. So you know that for hidden point, you can use also the Disto. Now you have X-Tilt, so maybe you will use X-Tilt, but you have the possibility to use also the Disto to take the distance for the hidden points. And now, before we was only compatible with some Bosch GLM, not the low energy, the other version, and with the Leica Disto, now we are also compatible with these two series of distanciometer. Okay, thank you very much for your participation. I hope you enjoyed the webinar. Now, let's see if we have any questions. So I see here a question. Let me open. So here the question is on the so we are talking about the X-Tilt, and the question is if you have to recalibrate the bubble. So the bubble, just to explain you how the system works. So what we calibrate, so here is, for example, my controller. So what we calibrate are the sensors inside the controller. So when you attach the tablet to the pole, you have a geometry between the inclination of the tablet and the verticality of the pole. What we are calibrating is exactly this one. So you keep the pole vertical and you calibrate the sensor of the tablet. So in this way, XPAD know what is how they have to be the tilt sensor of the tablet to match the verticality of the pole. In theory, you have to do it only after you attach the tablet. So you attach the tablet, you calibrate, and then you can do all your job. However, it is possible that during the job, maybe you move the holder. So the tablet is not exactly in the same position at the beginning, maybe it move a bit. So in this way, it is suggested to do a recalibration to recalculate what is the position of the and inclination of the tablet. But in general, so in theory, you have to do it only one time, sorry, before the job. Okay, you do one time and then you make your survey and you use X-Tilt. But it is recommended after sometimes to do it again. But the calibration at the end is so fast, you only need really 10 seconds, 15 seconds, and easy to do that at the end is not a problem if you do more times during the survey. Okay, here, so I hope to have understood the replied correctly to your question. Here is another question. So if the X-Tilt is only available in Android or also in Windows Mobile, no, the version, so what we have seen today, and in particular the X-Tilt, is only available for XPAD Ultimate Android. Why it is not available also? So for Windows Mobile, is not that we said, okay, we do not want this function for Windows Mobile. The problem is that on Windows Mobile, the Windows Mobile controller do not have the sensor that we need to use the X-Tilt. So this function is only available on Ultimate, because now also we sell much more Ultimate. So we want is where we are moving, as you probably has already seen, to develop the Android software, but is also because it is physically not possible to do the same on Windows Mobile. Okay, here a question, where are all these new features are available, where we can check these new features. So in our Geomax partner technical library, now we changed the name, opening the software XPAD Ultimate folder, there is possible to download a presentation, this presentation, but it's also possible to download a list of all the features that we introduced in not only in this service pack, because this is already the second service pack of this year. We already released one in April. So you can check everything that we released in our service pack. So from the first service pack until this one. Next service pack probably will be beginning of next year. Okay, now just before to conclude, I would like to let me open. Okay, I would like to remember you that if you open here our service and support webinar page on our website, here you have the possibility to see all the old webinar that we did. So we started this project of the webinar open to everyone this year. So here you can see all the webinar that we did this year. And here also you will find in few days the video also for this webinar. Okay, so I do not see any other questions. So I would like to thank you for your participation. And we wait you then also on Thursday for the other webinar that we will have, in this case, on XPAD Fusion, so our office software. So we will have in this case a webinar to see all together what is included in the service pack, but not for XPAD Ultimate for the tablet, but for the office software for XPAD Fusion. So thank you again and have a nice day.